And it was a band that kicked it off with 1, 2, 3 o'clock, 4 o'clock, 5, 6, 7 o'clock, 8 o'clock. Well, maybe you've heard that song, or maybe you've heard, "See you later, alligator, after my crocodile," Bill Haley and the Comets. Now, in 2008, when we were there, Bill Haley had already passed away. 1981, Bill Haley left this world, but his band, the Comets, still were traveling and performing. And in the early 2000s, they found their home nestled in the beautiful Ozark Mountains of Branson, Missouri. And they did a little 15 to 20 minute show, and then another act came out, a fellow from North Carolina named Billy Joe Royal, who had huge success not only with pop music, but country music. But one of his biggest songs, in my opinion, was a tune called "Down in the Boondocks." Maybe you've heard, "Down in the boondocks, down in the boondocks, people put me down, sad to side of town I was born in." Well, that was him. Now, he did a little part of a show there that night, and then, after he finished up, out came this fella named Bill Medley. Maybe you've heard of the Righteous Brothers before. Bill Medley and Bobby Hatfield together made up the duet, the Righteous Brothers. And they had songs like "Little Latin Lupe Lou" and "You Lost That Loving Feeling." Oh, that loving feeling. You've lost that loving feeling. Now it's gone, gone, gone. Oh, 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 oh. Well, here's Bill Medley from the Righteous Brothers, and he does his little part of him, the show. And I remember distinctly, 1990, I was 8 years old, and there was a movie that came out called Ghost that had Patrick Swayze and Demi Moore. Some of you ladies probably remember Patrick Swayze. Man, the ladies went crazy over that guy. He was a good actor, that's all I can say about him. But they had a movie called Ghost, and in this movie, there was this love scene. And him and Demi Moore are doing their thing, and this little record kicks on this jukebox. And all of a sudden, you hear the Righteous Brothers with this huge song that was just a blowout for them back in the 1960s. And it wasn't even their song. They were just covering it, like so many people did. But they did a beautiful job at it. And I gotta tell you, I was hoping he would do it, and he did. A little bit of "Unchained."